Hi, I am Dr. Selvaraj, your surgical educator from Malaysia. Welcome back to my series of surgical teaching videocasts. These are meant mainly for undergraduate medical students doing the surgical clerkship rotation. I promise you will become competent in clinical problem solving and surgical decision making if you are going to watch these videos over and over again. So in this episode, I am going to talk about one more image based question in lower GI tract pathology. So I have shown two pictures. So these patients presented with perianal discomfort. So these are the two clinical pictures and these are the five questions. Question number one, what is your diagnosis? Question number two, what is the symptomatology? Question number three, what are the predisposing factors? Question number four, how do you manage this condition? Question number five, what complications may arise after surgery for this, pathology? So I request my viewers to pause the video and try to answer all these five questions. After answering all the five questions, you can compare your answer with the correct answers which I am going to discuss in the subsequent slides. So question number one, what is the diagnosis? So the correct answer is prolapsed hemorrhoids. Here you are seeing prolapsed hemorrhoid. This is internal hemorrhoid and this is external. Third degree piles are reducible and fourth degree piles or hemorrhoids are irreducible. Both third and fourth degree are prolapsed, but the third degree manually you can reduce. But if it is fourth degree hemorrhoids, manually also you cannot reduce and it is irreducible. Question number two, what is the symptomatology? So patient will present with excruciating pain. Number two, bleeding, and number three is itching. So these are the three, symptoms or problems with which the patient will present to you. Question number three, what are the predisposing factors? The correct answer is prolonged straining at defecation, constipation, and pregnancy. So these are the risk factors for the patient to develop hemorrhoids. Question number four, how do you manage this condition? The correct answer is if they are reducible, advice on bowel regulation, having a high fiber diet, and avoidance of prolonged straining may be sufficient. Suppose if these prolapsed hemorrhoids are irreducible, then these hemorrhoids need surgical excision, that is called open or close hemorrhoidectomy you can do. Question number five, what complications may arise after surgery, that is after hemorrhoidectomy, what are the complications can arise? The correct answer is early complications and late complications. So the early complications is bleeding, infection, and acute retention of urine due to post-operative pain. The retention of urine is because of post-op pain. Bleeding, can happen if the ligature which you put slips, then bleeding will happen. You have to do a hemostasis. You have to take the patient to the theater and again you have to control the pedicle. So late complication, it could be incontinence because of injury to the sphincter complex or anal stricture formation, which is due to the excess amount of anal mucosa is resected during the surgery, that is leading to excessive scarring, and that is the cause for the stricture formation or anal stenosis or anal stricture. That is a late complication. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you think that these videos are very useful, Kindly subscribe to this channel and share these videos in your social media. Thank you once again for watching this video. Let us meet in another episode. Until then, bye-bye.